Hello everybody, welcome back to Scratch for Fun. Today we are doing a little bit more programming on our macerator, part 3 I guess. This is the second part we are coding though. So, where did we leave off last time? Well, we finished the GUI, so yes, now it's now nice and dandy. We can put, you know, stuff in here, stuff happens to the power level, stuff like that. Now, we are today going to do a little bit more fixing here. First of all, the power level depends on, it's basically progressing or scaling the power level depending on how much power this gives here, basically. And that basically is always going to say output 100%, which is not what we want. So what we are going to do is we're going to jump down here. It now basically divides it by this variable down here. Just wait 1 second here. Yes. So it's basically dividing the power. It's multiplying it by I, which is what we're scaling it around. Then it's dividing it by the maximum power, or that's what we want to do. First of all, we delete this stuff like here. This is not necessary at all. And current item burn time is soon going to be changed. We need a variable that displays us the max speed. So we're going to, not max speed, but the max power. So we're going to change this variable to be named max power. Now we need to initialize this variable. So we're going to set the max power of this furnace to 10,000, I guess, okay? 10,000, there you are. Now we do have some problems here. We probably have crashed as well. No, we haven't actually. Now max power, let's set, okay, max power. We can change this to max power as well. And then we change this to max power. Then we of course need to change this to max power. These two needs to be the same. We need can change power to power. Our burn time to power rather. Let's grab max power once more and let's continue on here. So now, thing is, we're not going to change the max power. We're not going to set the max power equal to this power. No. What we basically want to do is the max power is final. Okay, so we can set that up here, public int, public final int. This means you cannot change. You'll get an error if you try to change it. Here it tries to change the max power. We're going to delete that line right now. The same goes for this right here. No. No reason to save the max power if it's final. Now, the power amount is going to be equal to get item burn time. Now, that's not what we want. We want to add the get item burn time. But that means that we need to remove some items here as well. First of all, let's just check current item burn time. We need to change this to max power. There we go. This should now be scaled correctly. Current, the container here needs to be changed as well. Now, we're actually not going to have a progress bar update at max power because it's a final variable. There's no reason to change it. You can change it if you put this down here. You can't change it, it's a final. So we need to remove this line of code right here. We remove this right here and we remove wherever it says current item burn time or max power, basically. We are removing this right here as well, send progress bar update. We have now removed the second variable, okay? The reason for that is, well, send progress bar update basically updates the container kind of about values that's changing, okay? It's updating changing values. Now, our value is final, which means that it's not going to change at all, so we can just remove it from here. And that's basically what you need to remove. You need to remove where it says is equal to 2 down here, and it says max power or your Madueki. So it shouldn't be mentioning max power basically, okay? Then we jump down here, save that as well. Did this update automatically? let's just quit that. It says the power equal to... yes, that's something I need to tell you. First of all, it said it is a max power. It's 10,000, okay? And 10,000 equal to what, basically, or what are we kind of comparing it to? Well, in get item burn time, this is basically the current list right here of the stuff we can smelt. It says here wood gives you 300 power. Coal blocks give you 16,000, which is way over what's basically kind of allowed. It's over the max here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this entire get item burn time. We're going to rename it to get power. Okay. And let's save that. Now we need to update some stuff up here. Get power. And we need to jump down here. Get power. Now in here as well, there's some other stuff we need to remove. First of all, we want this line right here. We can remove the line under, for now at least, and then we can remove most of these lines, okay? Down to this crap right here. Not a real recipe, okay? We'll remove that. And instead of returning get value right here from game registry, that's basically other mods, we're going to return 0 from now. For now, if any mods ask you to do stuff, just create a core API, I guess, for them to use for you. Shouldn't be that hard. But yeah, probably if you watch my tutorials, you might have a problem creating that. But never mind, never mind. Instead of get power, it should say get item power, I guess. Item power, get a power. Yeah, here we go. Now, we don't want sticks, coal, bucket of lava, saplings to be fuel, and stuff like that. Now, we want, or I want, redstone. Now, it's not going to give you 24,000 power. It is going to give you, let's say, 10 power, okay? Now, this basically means that your furnace can run for 10 ticks with one redstone, basically, okay? Now, how many ticks does it take to macerate an item? That's your furnace speed up here, which is 125. So it basically takes 12 and a half redstone to macerate your item. That's a little bit high, so we're going to change this value down to 70. We're going to change this macerating speed. We're going to jump down here again, update the macerating speed variable down here. Nice and easy. Let's jump up again. Now, we don't want to use 7 redstone. Well, we actually do, won't we? Well, you can figure out this for yourself. How many redstone do you think is appropriate for basically per ore, okay? If you use 7 redstone to macerate one ore into, of course, two dusts or more, you know, you need to kind of look at that. Not only change the macerating speed, but also change the power output of one redstone as well. Now you can of course add more of these. Just copy this line, paste it down under, and you can use one of your own items as well. I do not have any items at the moment, but just add your own modding class right here. Then you add the name of your item. If it's a block works as well. You just change this to block ID right here. And then you set how many ticks of power you want this to be. Quite simple, quite simple. Now, is item fuel actually used? I'm not sure. Doesn't seem like it's used up here. It's used down here. Is item valid for slot? Okay, so we need this method. Okay, that's nice. Let's move up again here. We got some stuff we've commented out. Now you don't want to comment too much out, or you know, stuff will break. So let's figure this out right now. First of all, we want to make sure that we don't want to add power if we can smelt. We want to be able to add power all the time, and by smelt, I mean, let's just launch this right here. It shouldn't take too long. Opens up already. And 3-1. Single player, world 2. So now by power, now by can smelt, it basically tells you, is there an item in here? If it is an item, it returns true. Or if it is an item that can smelt, it returns true. Now, that's not what we want. We want to make sure that we get power, and that the power amount is less than zero. Because, well, now we're talking about adding fuel, okay? So we don't care if there's an item here or not when we're adding fuel, right? It only matters here. So what we are going to do, right now we said that redstone is a fuel, so you can take off one redstone. It doesn't use it up. It is so little that it doesn't display here at all. So we need a little bit more redstone to fix this problem. But first of all, we want to change some stuff here. Now, we only want to add power if we are not at the max amount of power. So let's change this right here. If this dot power is less than this dot max power, now we want to say minus this dot get item power, and then the item stack. Which item stack is this? Well, it's slot number one. Slot number one, it was down here. We moved slot number one down over here. So we know that, okay, if it's less or equal, we should say, to the max power minus the amount of power this will suffice, basically. Now, that's not the only thing we want to do. We also want to make sure that there is actually any power in here. So before we do this, we want to say this dot, and let's create a new method, shall we? Let's jump down here. Or let's rename is item valid for slot. Let's rename is item fuel. Let's rename it to is item power. Or does item have power? Something like that. Let's copy this over here as well. Nice and easy. Let's jump up here again. So let's say this dot is item power. And then we're going to say this dot slots I. Okay. Basically tells us if there's any power to this item or not. If there is any power, it makes sure that we have space for more power, and then we want to add the power, not only set the power equal, but we want to add the power, and then we want to burn stuff down. Okay, now first of all, we have some flags up here. Okay, the flags are more down here as well. So if flag one is equal to true, the inventory has changed. Okay, now the inventory can change multiple times, you know, stuff like that. Now the inventory changes if you update the block state, if you remove a block and add another block. You know, that's basically this method right here. Deletes one block from the ground and places another one faster than you can see. No stuff popping out. It's just basically it's removing the, for example, the burning stuff and tasting the other stuff. So what we want to tell the game is that we want to say flag one is equal to true. Okay, this has changed. The GUI has changed. We removed one item here. We want you to update the inventory, okay? And then we want to remove this item, okay? So first of all, we want to say this dot slots. Slots I is not equal to null. We can actually rem oh, I shouldn't have saved. We should, could actually remove this down here, this flag. So now we know, okay, there is an item here. Let's set this dot slots of I dot stack size to less, and then we want to make sure that if the stack size is now zero, then you know, delete the item. So we're going to say this dot, now item stacks work a little bit weird, so we need to set this equal to this dot slots, or the last time I tried at least, dot get item dot get container item here, I think. No, item stack. Stack. Here, not weed, sorry. Then this dot slots of I. It doesn't work weed, my bad. what you say when you're on camera. Yes, container items are basically like buckets. If you put a bucket in, you basically want an empty bucket out, for example. It basically sets the container item. It might be null, but it would just take care of that as well. So we can now remove the stuff that's down here. If you want a bucket of power, if you have a bucket of redstone, for example, and want that to power your furnace or macerator, then you want a empty bucket out of it, most certainly. Down here it says is item fuel. Got an error here. Is item power, or let's change that. Has, so much better. Has power, has item power. Let's change, jump down here. Is item power, has item power, has item power, and has item power. There we go. Beautiful. So now we can basically add power to the stuff. Now we can't smelt yet. This is what we need to do here. It's raining. Weather clear. There we go. Oh, that's not valid number. Come on. Probably a few too many of those. So, there we go. Clear weather. Yes, we can jump in here and we can add one redstone. Okay, so it didn't add. We need to. We crashed it basically, and I said, if you crash, just not crash at all, just stay like you were before you crash, basically. So one redstone, we add one redstone. Redstone gets kind of deleted, and it's now more power in the macerator. Okay, we can add a stack, and we say draw, and the power actually goes up. So now we have power in our macerator. Okay, isn't that beautiful? Oh yeah, so you need to add a lot of redstone. We're soon going to add cables and stuff like that to the mod as well. So we don't need to fuel in with a lot of redstone. But of course you can make the redstone a lot more worth, or you can make the macerator house less redstone, stuff like that. So yeah, beautiful, a lot of power. Now the power should be saved, hopefully, or we'll need to change that as well. Yes, the power is saved. You can log out, power is still there. And then we want to make sure that you can use the power to macerate objects, okay? But for now it's going to smelt, but in the future it's going to macerate. But I guess that's everything we managed to do in today's episode. So yeah, sorry for that. A little bit shorter episode today because I made a very long one last time. Whew. But yeah, thanks so much for hearing, everybody. My name is ScratchFan. Make sure to hit the like button, and I'll catch you guys in my next one. So yeah, goodbye, and have a nice day.